Yeah. Street life.
Yeah, street life. Life as we know it today. That's just my style of...
Yeah.
Some modern stickman.
Starry, starry night, paint your palette blue and gray. Look out on a summer's day with eyes that know the darkness in my soul. Shadows on the hills, sketch the trees and the daffodils. Catch the breeze and the winter chills in colors on the snowy linen land. Now I understand what you tried to say to me, and how you suffered for your sanity, and how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they did not know how. Perhaps they'll listen now. Starry, starry night, flaming flowers that brightly blaze, swirling clouds in violet haze, reflect in Vincent's eyes of china blue, colors changing hue. Morning fields of amber grain, weathered faces lined in pain, are soothed beneath the artist's loving hand. Now I understand what you tried to say to me, and how you suffered for your sanity, and how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they did not know how. Perhaps they'll listen now, for they could not love you, but still your love was true. And when no hope was left in sight on that starry, starry night, you took your life as lovers often do. But I could have told you, Vincent, this world was never meant for one as beautiful. Starry, starry night, portraits hung in empty halls, frameless heads on nameless walls, with eyes that watch the world and can't forget, like the strangers that you've met. The ragged men in ragged clothes, a silver thorn, a bloody rose, lie crushed and broken on the virgin snow. Now I think I know what you tried to say to me, and how you suffered for your sanity, and how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they're not listening still. Perhaps they never will.
We're in Eccles Community Art Gallery at the moment, and how did you meet up with Karen Illingworth?
Just by the amount of people, friends and family have seen my stuff, and even them encouraging me to go and put it somewhere else.
What do you think about it, the art gallery?
Yeah, it's good, there's a community, like to see what new talents are there. The first thing I painted was one was actually in the gallery, and it was just like three hoodies in a bag. Emotions, I don't know. But I needed something, nothing was... Nothing was taking my mind off anything. And just my girlfriend mentioned one day, because she does like little bits of sketches, where you get a pad and some pencil, something, do a little bit of drawing, and it takes your mind off stuff. So I got some, and that's like I say, started out doing little rubbish sketches and that, and I started practicing them little hoodie faces. That's how I ended up combining them into my pictures and that. So one day they were up in a big gallery somewhere.
You want to end up in the Lowry?
Yeah, in the Lowry somewhere. Like you say, first instincts of it, because it's hoodies and that, you might think some...
Cool.
A folk's drawn it, you know, that's something like what you might expect of somebody like me.
Yeah, it's street life.
Yeah, street life. Some modern stickman.
Alright folks, DJ Joe Salford here with information on local artists and local goings on and the like. This week's music to listen out for is M44, Brixie and our very own Joe Coffey.
This is the life of a Salford soldier. He carries around a big weight on his shoulder. I'll tell you about one of these kids while I'm rhyming. Living life on the edge, putting some time in. It's a life of rhyme, I'll go through it in stages. This kid'll do what it takes just to make some wages. You won't find the hood life business in the yellow pages. If this kid goes hungry, he's gonna start thieving. He looks up to the corner boys, he likes the way they're dealing. His ma buys him some new trainers, but they've got no name on. She says, it's all I can afford, I'm struggling son. He's not looking forward to school in the morning. If anyone laughs at his trainers, he won't give him a warning. The kid's got nothing, even his hand-me-down jumper's got holes in. A lad who's been bullying him starts with a name calling. The kid's got nothing to lose now, so he gives him a beating. My ma bought me these trainers, so they're good enough to put my feet in. All the money he took off me, tomorrow I'll collect. The kid walks away with his head held high and a new type of respect. Kid gets home and the house is freezing. His ma can't afford to put on essential eating. She's spent the last bit of money on food, at least he's eating. His dad isn't around, he doesn't half miss him. He can't wait for him to get out of Strange Ways prison. The kid takes a look at his life, he doesn't like what he's seeing. He walks up to the corner boys to see what they're saying. The kid tells me, I wanna be like you, I wanna be gangster. Don't try and run before you can walk, go home youngster. He walks away, they didn't wanna know him. The kid doesn't give up, he just thinks I'll show him. Now he's the man of the house while his dad isn't around. He decides to go out grafting to make a few pounds. He's out with their kid and his mate, break into a factory. They leave no boxes behind, they clear it out properly. These kids have found their own way of escaping poverty. Yesterday, he had snide trainers, so did his mate. Now they're selling the best ones all over the estate. Now this kid's growing up, he's doing his own thing. He's mooching round in his Jeep and he's covered in bling. As he stops to look up at the telephone wire, he sees his no-name trainers he grew up there when he set his sights higher. Them trainers have got some history, he wore them with pride, not shame. Now he's become notorious in Manchester's drug game. It makes him take a look at his life and wonders who's to blame. Half of his mates and family are in prison and his closest friend is a shotter. He's still got his hand-me-down jumper made by Carlotta.